Hello for Thursday, December 11th. A pretty good day. We had some good breakouts. And also I want to mention like EGLE, Eagle. Remember yesterday how it ran up about 45% intraday and then it backed off just a little bit. It gapped up in the morning on Wednesday and we put on the blog. It was then up about, I don't know, 70%. And just from the, obviously it's gone up more than that. We only got in on a Tuesday. So it was up 70%. So we said, you know, keep those profits. Obviously, it could gap again. But look, when you get 70% in 2 days, how often does that happen? Even with like 1,000 shares at like $4? Well, you know, you made a lot of money. So maybe you'll get a chance to buy lower again. Maybe it'll move up. Maybe it won't. But anyway, make sure you keep your profits when we have these big moves like that. We had another good one that broke out on Wednesday. And that is WMGI, as you can see. Nice move. Look at this volume. So this one could increase as well. We like, we said yesterday in the video, we do like these setups when we get into a bull kind of run. Because if we're in a real bull market, they practically always just, they're real dependable to go up to this kind of resistance like here, 1860. I'm sorry, the 1960 or the 2173. We're not in a real bull market. We're in a bull phase of a bear market. We're in a bear market rally. And quite often, you know, as we hit these bottoms in October or November, a lot of stocks double. I mean, that's very common for stocks to double, and we've got many that have almost done that from those lows. Now, here's the Dow. This is a junky-looking chart because we had the Fibonacci and some other lines on here. But we said in yesterday's video how we didn't like the setups and we wouldn't really play it, and there were maybe some plays in today, but not great. But at least now what we have is we do have a trend line. We said why we didn't like it before. There's no places where you could put in a real good clean break. Now this would be on the upsides here. If it consolidates in here a little ways further when we move along. If then it breaks, it's clean. That doesn't mean it's going to go, but it's very clean. It doesn't have a lot. It's got one clear point over here because of the long red candle. So one clear point of resistance. So that means if it breaks out, it's liable to test that right away. So if it fails, you get out with some profit. Or if it moves, then the next point of resistance is really that top again. So that's what we like to see. That's why we say sit on your hands some days till you get better. On the downside, of course, it could break underneath this double bottom that it created. Doesn't have much to go, though, before it hits the, actually it would then hit the 200 period in the bottom trend line, which we've drawn through this drop down here. Those are the points to watch as this sets up, so it should break one way or the other Thursday or Friday. If we look at the S&P 500, now this one's kind of interesting because it's gone virtually just straight sideways for a couple of days, 3 days in a row, just like this. It made a double bottom, so of course these double bottoms, you know, with indexes, since it's so widely viewed, they quite often will bounce. They're not all successful. This one was, so you could have played the bounce play for, what, about 9 points, which was, you know, it's good. It's not pocket change. It's pretty decent. You can see when that bounced here, this was also stochastics was under 20. But if you're waiting for a clean break, that would be also. Didn't like this setup before, but now it's better because we've got 1, 2, 3 touches. So above this trend line, that would be an upside buy automatic. Even if the, I think stochastics, it wouldn't be your best play because we don't have low stochastics or RSI, as you can see. But still, it's a normal play, a trend line breakout because you put your stop really close. And then we'll look at the Russell real quickly. And that is, also, we didn't like that setup yesterday, but again, we like it because it has now formed a triangle. The bottom one is only 2 touches, still valid. The upper one, it closed almost at the top of it because it moved up about 2%, about 10 bucks. It's pretty decent. And the only buy signals here was just the stochastics. As it moved up, we don't yet have any crossover on the MACD. So maybe some played it that way. I wouldn't. I'd sit on my hands and wait for this kind of setup. Where now if it gaps up over, too bad. You wait for the new setup, in my opinion. You want to make sure that you, unless you're really experienced, you protect capital. And you wait for a good clean setup. So if this consolidates a little bit more and then breaks out or breaks down, those would be possible plays. Now, in the day, we pointed out in the blog that golds were moving like mad. We don't always show golds all the time because you know the ones to watch. We have about 5 or 6 favorites, and you can buy those when you want. They're moving up for long. As you can see, this was the low in October. So they'll be moving up, we think, right along for some time to come. But as you see, each time they've got lower lows and higher highs. That's what we'd like to see. Anyway, I just want to point out that the HUI, this is Gold Bugs. This stands for, BUG stands for Basket of Unhedged Gold Stocks. So as you can see, it broke out above this 248 top over here. It moved up from there. So it's just on the path to continue, even if it pulls back at some point. And so as a result, we'll add a couple of, we'll add gold and silver on the watch list. We do have others that you know about. Now, FRG, I think this was on the watch list in the past, and I don't see it now. Maybe it was too long ago. It's been, you know, it's gone to the secondary page. We had it as a possible buy in here, interchannel, and it moved up a little bit, then came down. But we were watching it all this time to see if it come down the bottom. It never got that far. It just came down this far. But I just want to mention it did break out, and it closed above the 50-day, the first time since back in September. So if, and it had good volume as well. It's not on the watch list. There's no clean area. But if you like this kind of chart pattern, and I basically do, if it pulls back in this area, you even test the 50-day, this may be one to buy. So I'm just pointing it out. Okay, now the additions. We've got WPP over $10.50. This is kind of like a cup and then a long kind of handle. Not super because it's not very volatile. But I sometimes, some people like these if you work and don't want, it can be volatile, but you can see it's not as volatile as some, so this may be one over 1046. Now, with some of these, look for a longer term chart to see. There is some resistance off to the left. We can't fit it on this video. It wouldn't look good on the chart, but always look at a longer time frame chart to see. But you see it does have a golden cross here. That's positive when the 200-day goes below the 50-day. Okay, next up, we've got all of these are longs. We've got Faro. Now, Faro, remember, this was on our watch list before as a break of this trend line that we don't have draw. It did break and moved up. And the only reason I'm putting it back on is because now it's back above the 50-day. This is a very low volume stock, so not everyone can trade it. It only did 59,000. But sometimes, if it gets going, it'll do 200,000. Anyway, we just put it on, and you can watch this if you're interested in this. At one time, this was a real good moving stock. Okay, Goodyear Tire. You know, the auto industry, I didn't know how that affects it, but quite often you'll see tires move at the weirdest times, and this doesn't seem like people are going to be buying cars, and why would tires go up? But I guess it was oversold. Anyway, Goodyear sometimes can perform well, in this case over about $6.90 or $7 if the volume comes in on this. That's GT. HBI also, and a couple. This one also tried to break a little bit here. You can see 1550. Oh, this one sold off. Sorry. 1553 was the former high, and 1533 is a 50-day EMA. Use your judgment on that. I think 1550 would be fine if it has good volume. It's very weak right now, which is fine in consolidation. But if it starts to move, we want to see good volume on HBI. Also, remember to go to our watch list where you see the full-size charts of all of these if we're going too fast or if they're too small. Now, DDUP, this one has been pulling back, and we should wait to put it on the list, but sometimes if we wait, all of a sudden they spring on us. I also don't like the higher volume on the first day, but it stayed above the 50-day. That's why we put it on the list. If it can stay and go sideways here, then we've got it on the list. You know to set your alerts in Quote Tracker or whatever you use above 19, but we think DDUP could be a buy. Now, USO, remember this, USD, I'm sorry, it's the ETF for the semiconductor industry. And, you know, semis went up even on the bad news of the chip makers, and it ran up again, but it had good volume. So I think if this can hold above the trend line, this could be a buy, and we don't have a buy price on it. We're just showing it to you because, you know, it's broken out of the channel. You want to watch because if the techs stay good, this one could move on up into the $18 area. Whole Foods, WFMI, over $11.25. It then has a second level a little bit above that. It also needs good volume for that to be a buy. And we've got a couple more quickly. We've got HL. This is a silver play, as you know. And this one would be over $2.35. It closed near to that. And also AUY, which is gold. We bought it originally. Oh, we didn't buy this, but it's gone up almost double. We bought a lot of our stocks over here. But over 584 put it to a new high for this time period, and also over the 50-day EMA. So those are the additions for today. Thanks a lot for coming by the site. Hope you have a good trading day, and we'll be back tomorrow with some new ideas. Bye-bye.